you are curious about AI-powered generative design, but you hesitate to press the start button. Don't be. But is it easy to learn it? The answer is yes. The most important thing is practicing every necessary step and understanding the case study, which is creating robotic arm gripper using generative design. And thanks a lot, our video sponsor, PCBWay.com. This generatively designed 3D printed part is manufactured and delivered by PCBWay.com services. Before diving into the video, don't forget to subscribe to Designwagoon channel and like the video. In this tutorial, we're revealing how generative design works in Fusion 360 and some additive manufacturing techniques. Let's get started! Hi, this is Cengiz from Designwagoon channel. In this video, we're going to explain the generative design model in Fusion 360. Quickly, I would like to explain why I need to use generative design approach for this project. Our remote control rescue robot project is structured as one vehicle and a robotic arm in front of it. So, as you think, the gripper part should be as much as light because of the moment issue. Well, generative design is exactly creating as part as you assigned the algorithm. Okay, I'll explain everything in the next step. But first, let's open the box which I received from PCBWay.com. After I upload my generative designed robotic arm gripper, I choose the manufacturing type, material, and etc. Then I received my 3D printed part in 9 working days from China to France after I ordered. Well, as you know, it's quite fast for international shipment, but you have several other options, faster or cheaper. I actually like the flexibility in PCBWay.com because they created a service that is quite flexible as your wishes, like manufacturing techniques, material selection, shipment options. So let's start with how you can prepare your part for generative design in Fusion 360. First, I designed a servo motor holder as a gripper part for my project. Then I used the split body tool to define the necessary part for the next steps. In generative design study, it should be assigned to preserve geometry that allows adding loads and constraints. Preserved geometries also will appear in the final shape of the design. So, in my case, the preserved geometries should be the edge of servo motor holder sides, screw regions, and holding side of the rest of robotic arm. By the way, it's not obligatory to add obstacle geometry in generative design study, but in many cases, it will help you when you need to assign obstacle barrier spaces where the material is placed during the generation of outcome. Basically, it's the regions that you don't prefer to create a mesh region. Well, the most important feature that distinguishes generative design from topology optimization is that GD creates the part using AI-powered algorithms while taking into account the manufacturing techniques you selected. Now, in manufacturing of generative design model, it's available additive which you can choose and assign the parameters of orientation, overhang angle, and minimum thickness. It's also available in milling, which is included as 5, 3, and 2.5 axis. You can assign your custom tool settings as minimum tool diameter, tool shoulder length, and head diameter. Also, you can choose the 2-axis cutting manufacturing option or the die casting manufacturing technique. The term generative design is not a brand new phenomenon. Since the 90s, people have been using generative design. However, it has never had the widespread use and application that it does now in different industries like automotive, aeronautics, architectures, and etc. The generative design process requires not only determination of parameters, but also an analysis of the best solution at the results or outcomes. An AI, artificial intelligence, just lacks the ability to comprehend the design problem on its own, at least for now. It just operates in accordance with the input design goal. Well, basically, if you take a look at the workflow of generative design, we need a CAD computer-aided design project. After we determine the related parts of project, we can define the preserve and obstacle bodies that I mentioned in previous section of the video. Then we can assign all necessary parameters like manufacturing techniques, materials, objectives or limits, design conditions, etc. After we obtain the results geometries, we can easily compare them. Then we can decide the final design geometry, which is created by generative design. After you switch the explore page of Fusion 360, you'll see the outcomes which is created by generative design. It could be 5 or 50 different outcomes based on your parameters as manufacturing techniques or materials. Well, I'm pretty sure you'll make it work. I'd like to dig into comparing 4 different outcomes. As you can see, I can isolate any preferences of outcome filters, which is in a user-friendly interface. So these outcomes are created for different aims, and obviously they have different mesh geometries. After you select the optimum design outcome, you can change the iteration number as you wish. Then I export the selected outcome to the design workspace. If you are a mechanical engineer or if you are a member of a similar engineering discipline, you already know how important to prepare your part before you send it to manufacture. After you export your generative design outcome, you'll have a chance to modify your T-spline model in organic modeling workspace. If you'd like to get more information about T-spline modeling, you can take a look at our video of designing a plane for 3D printer. Well, I think I have to modify the geometry for manufacturing in 3D printer, but how can I know the custom properties of 3D printers? Well, there are lots of guide information in PCBWay.com, not just for 3D printing, also they are delivering services of CNC machining, sheet metal fabrication, injection molding, and of course, PCB prototype and assembly. You can use the Fusion 360 for all of designing processes for your project. You can check out our video of what is Fusion 360 even if you are an advanced user, because Fusion has 8 different workspaces to bring your project idea to life. After I export generative design outcome as STL, I easily select the get a 3D printing quote. Then I'm uploading my STL file or other formats available to PCBWay.com. Most common materials are available. You'll just pick them up as you wish, and the manufacturing technique is changing based on your material selection. You can select the base color for your part, and also there is a surface finish tool, which is quite important for good looking for your parts. There are dozens of colors you can pick. It's so easy to use. I'd like to explain the importance of technical drawing. If your part has specific dimensions like screw centers, holes, and etc., you can create a quick technical drawing and add it to your order. Also, you can preview your 3D data on PCBWay.com, which is quite useful to check your part dimensions, volume, and some other details for your 3D part. Well, after I submitted a request on PCBWay.com, I quickly received an email about my 3D part. They investigate my STL file and decided to available for 3D printing. There are several 3D printing techniques like FDM, SLA, SLM, and etc. You can find detailed information on these different 3D printing techniques. I choose SLS, selective laser sintering, which is an industrial 3D printing process that produces accurate prototypes and functional production parts in as fast as one day. As a material, I choose the nylon PA12, which is a durable material with great impact strength, medium flexibility, and high resistance to environmental factors. And the tolerances are so important for every manufacturing technique. You'll have a chance to take a look at your preferred technique. If you are curious about shipment options, as I said before, there are lots of options depend on time of delivery and weight of the part. Finally, I finished my order process. Then you'll receive emails about every new step notification. Also, you can check your order progress in PCBWay.com. Well, I quickly show you how you can export your files and technical drawings. You can always use the export option from the file icon. Also, you can use the make tool, then the 3D print tool, which is capable to send your 3D data to your printer software. Or if you unselect the icon, you can easily create STL or 3MF file format. So technical drawings are quite important to tell your 3D part details to manufacturers. After you finish adding all details to your data, you can export as a PDF your technical drawing. I also want to mention about 3D PCB design in Fusion 360. Your PCB data at the same time is your mechanical data. So cool, right? You have to check this out, and maybe you can create your own PCB design, and you'll probably want to manufacture it easily and affordable price using PCBWay.com. Well, I hope you liked the video, and if you want to create the same design projects, you can find the link to my Autodesk University class below. And if you like to learn much detail about generative design, you can find the link to my course below. And you'll have a chance to enroll with a discount coupon. And I have a question for you. What do you want to learn about 3D designing or 3D printing? Please just drop a comment below and let us know about your thoughts. We are also creating interesting videos on Instagram Designwagoon channel. You can also find the link below. If you'd like to see more tutorials about Fusion 360 and designing, subscribe to Designwagoon channel on YouTube. Hope to see you next tutorials.